for each other has grown, turning them into the couple that stands before you. Now they are ready to spend the rest of their lives together as husband and wife. A true marriage begins well before the wedding day, and the efforts of marriage continue well beyond the ceremony. A brief moment in time and the stroke of a pen are all that are required to create the legal bond of marriage, but it takes a lifetime of love, commitment, and compromise to make a marriage durable and everlasting. Today, you declare your commitment to each other before friends and family. Kelsey and Paul, in addition to being two of the most beautiful humans I've ever and very closely resembling Barbie and Ken, are two of the most kind, compassionate, caring, and fun-loving people I've ever had the pleasure of knowing. Kelsey's kindness, motivation, and continuing dedication to always better herself and those around her are a few of the reasons that everyone loves, or are a few of the reasons why everyone loves her. Paul's intelligence, charm, and unwavering loyalty to those he loves are a couple of attributes that make him such an incredible man. There are a million little things that let the world know how special the love you two share is. But I think the most compelling fact is that Kelsey, you are marrying a man who wore only purple zebra pants and a Dante Culpepper jersey every day for 5 years of his life. Despite Paul's fashion faux pas, I've never met two people more suited for marriage. They keep each other grounded and happy. Their love is unconditional and insurmountable. When reflecting on the meaning of marriage, Kelsey and Paul came across a poem that Mary would like to share with all of you.
To be unconditionally loved is our birthright, and we are so loved by God. We desire just such a love from one another, and we deserve it. Yet it's a human quality to look for love before giving it. Thus, many of us search intently for signs of love. Too many of us are searching rather than loving. Truly loving another means letting go of all expectations. It means full acceptance, even celebration of another's personhood. Not easy, but so rewarding to ourselves, as well as to the one who is the focus of our love. Love is a balm that heals. Love lightens our burdens, whatever they are. It invites our inner joy to emerge, but most of all, it connects us, one with another. Loneliness leaves, we are no longer alienated from our environment. Love is the mortar that holds the human structure together. Without the expression of love, it crumbles. Partnership offers us a plan for loving each other as well as ourselves. Love will come to us just as surely as we give it away.
Thank you, Mary. That was beautiful. At this time, Kelsey and Paul will light the unity candle. Kelsey and Paul, together as you light the candle of unity, you symbolize the flame of your own individual selves joining to ignite the partnership of marriage. You also bring the warmth, strength, and wisdom of your family's fire as kindling for your own. As bride and groom, your flames are separate, yet they feed the same fire. Kelsey and Paul, please take your candles and light the center candle. Here to celebrate the wedding of Paul and Kelsey, and there's a lot to celebrate. But we must try and remember that a wedding is a symbol, a heartfelt and meaningful symbol, but a symbol nonetheless. The ceremony is not magic, it will not create a relationship that does not already exist and has not already been celebrated in all the commitments Paul and Kelsey have made to each other, both large and small, in the days since they first met. What we are celebrating today is not the beginning of a marriage, but a marriage already in progress. The ceremony is a symbol of how far they've come together and a symbol of the promises that they will continue to make together throughout their lives. If you ask couples who have a strong, abiding love what they like most about their partners, many will say when they are with that person, they don't have to pretend to be anything other than what they are. They are able to express themselves
smiles in crowded rooms. Marriage is saying I love you randomly and frequently. It's having a partner to stand with and face the world. It's never having to go through hard times alone. It's taking on each other's student loans. But most importantly, marriage is getting to spend every day with your best friend. One of the reasons Kelsey and Paul's relationship is so special is that it was built on the foundation of friendship. Since seventh grade, Kelsey and Paul have been best friends and partners in crime, as Kelsey so eloquently expresses their relationship. When I asked Kelsey and Paul to each describe what the other means to them, I was truly touched by the sincerity, respect, and genuine love that each shared in their respective answers. Kelsey describes Paul as the most patient, kind, gentle, and hardworking man she's ever had the pleasure of knowing. Paul always knows how to pick Kelsey up when she's down, never fails to put a smile on her face, and continues to make her laugh every day. Paul makes Kelsey feel strong, smart, and beautiful. But above all else, Kelsey describes Paul as the one person she simply wouldn't want to go through life without. When interrogating Paul about what Kelsey means to him, he describes Kelsey as the one person ever since middle school whose opinion he's always wanted, respected, and valued. He was always looking to impress Kelsey, and Paul made sure to disclose that this wasn't because she was attractive and popular, but because she's genuine and true to herself. Ever since they started dating in high school, the things Paul loves about Kelsey haven't changed or wavered, one of those being her sense of self. Whether times are good or bad, Paul describes Kelsey as always staying true to herself. He's in constant awe of her strength and courage. They each describe one another as playing influential roles in shaping the person they've grown into. Together, Kelsey and Paul keep each other balanced. No matter what stressful thing may be impacting their lives, these two have created a safe haven with one another, someone to tackle all of life's problems with. I can't imagine two people more suited for marriage. Kelsey and Paul, before this moment, you two have been many things. Classmates, friends, boyfriend and girlfriend, partner, fiance. But now you'll exchange a few words that'll take you across the threshold, and things will never quite be the same between you two. But in the same sense, and what's truly the most beautiful part, is that things will be exactly the same. Only your title and taxes will change. You fell in love by chance, but you're here today because you're making a choice. You're both choosing each other. You've chosen to be with someone who enhances you, who makes you think, makes you smile, and makes every day brighter. You're about to make promises to each other that you intend to keep. You're going to vow to take care of each other, to stand up for one another, and to find happiness in the other. There's a simple premise to each one of these promises. You're vowing to be there. So with that, do you, Paul, take Kelsey to be your lawfully wedded wife from this day forward to have and to hold, for better, for worse, for richer and for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish till death do you part?
I do.
Do you, Kelsey, take Paul to be your lawfully wedded husband from this day forward to have and to hold, for better, for worse, for richer and for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish till death do you part?
I do.
Please take the ring you have selected for Kelsey. As you place it on her finger, repeat after me. Kelsey, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love.
Kelsey, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love.
I ask you to wear it.
I ask you to wear it.
As a sign to the world that you are my wife.
As a sign to the world that you are my wife.
With this ring, I wed thee.
With this ring, I wed thee.
Kelsey, please take the ring you have selected for Paul. As you place it on his finger, repeat after me. Paul, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love.
Paul, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love.
I ask you to wear it.
I ask you to wear it.
As a sign to the world that you are my husband.
As a sign to the world that you are my husband.
With this ring, I wed thee.
With this ring, I wed thee.
By the power vested in me by the state of Minnesota, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.